Learning temperature and humidity transmitters. This is the Massibus MEEC humidity and temperature transmitter model HT7S11. This transmitter has humidity range 0 to 100% and temperature is 0 to 50 degrees centigrade with two outputs 4 to 20 milliampere each. And this is the sensing element, you can see here a rod which has got a fine hole in it through which it senses the air temperature and humidity. So now we will open this upper cover of this sensor so that we can assess the control terminals where we have to make connections. So by opening this four screws, we can assess the terminals of this sensor. We have opened it and now we can see here there is a electronic circuit, sensing circuit, and which has got four terminals. These are the four terminals where we have to make connections. Two terminals are for temperature signal and two are for relative humidity RH. So temperature terminals are marked as T plus and T minus. These are the left two terminals, T plus and T minus. RH plus and RH minus are the right side terminals, which we can see here. These are the relative humidity terminals. Here we have to make connections so that we can get 4 to 20 milliampere signal. Now let's see the diagram, connection diagram, how we have to make wiring. We have a 24 volt DC power supply and positive DC will be connected to the RH plus and T plus terminals, and RH minus and T minus will be signal wires. Now we will make connections as per our diagram. We are connecting a DC positive, which is a red wire, to the T plus terminal and RH plus terminal. So see here we have just now connected DC positive to RH plus and T plus terminals. In this way we have looped it DC positive. Now we will make another connections, which is T minus and RH minus. So this is the white wire which we are using for other terminal T minus. Actually this now we will in the same way we are using another wire for RH minus signal, and here we will connect it in this way. This is basically a two wire connection in which we move DC and get back 4 to 20 milliampere signal from the other terminal. So we have completed our connection of this transmitter. Now we will use a scanner module to get the display of this signal, and this is basically a 8 channel scanner, universal scanner of massive bus make, and this is the connection diagram of scanner, and 1 and 2, these are the line and neutral terminals so that this module will be powered up. And as this is a channel 2, channel 1, channel 2, these are the milliampere, volt and thermocouple, RTD. These are all type of signals which we can connect here in this universal scanner module, but we have to connect 4 to 20 milliampere signal, and these are the terminals you can see here. If we will zoom it, you can clearly see here that milliampere signal at channel number 2 is connected at 17 and 18, and here also you can see here for milliampere signal we have to connect 100 ohm resistance across these two terminals where we will be connecting milliampere wires. So we have to use 100 ohm resistance also, because it is indicated in its connection diagram. These are the backside of this module, and we have got all the terminals as per this diagram mentioned in it. These are the line and neutral terminal which we have already connected a power supply 220 volt. And now we will use channel number 2 to connect to milliampere signal. So we will use 17 and 18 terminal. Terminal number 17 and 18 will be used for milliampere connection of our signal. So these are the two 17 and 18 terminals, and we will connect here our milliampere signal. So this is basically a temperature signal, white wire which we have. Now this is the 100 ohm resistance, 100 ohm, which we will connect. So at one side this I am connecting. And this is 17, terminal number 17, where we are connecting the signal wire 4 to 20 milliampere of temperature signal along with a 100 ohm resistance, one side of it. Now we will use a DC common. So the other side of this is the DC common black wire, and the other side of this resistance will be connected with this wire, DC common. And both of these will now be connected to the terminal number 18. So we have connected our 4 to 20 milliampere temperature signal with 100 ohm resistance across it. You can see here, in this way our connection is complete for temperature signal. Terminal number 17 and 18, and this is the resistance which is across these terminals as shown in our connection diagram of this controller basically. In the same way, we will connect humidity signal also. So we will use another resistance with this humidity wire. This is a channel 3. And this is a common wire. And this is a DC common which we will connect. We can connect this at here also, because here also we are getting DC common. So we have completed both the connections of temperature and humidity at this scanner module, so that we can get the display of this signals. See here we have connected as per our connection diagram. And now we will switch on this system. We will power up it, and this is showing at the upper side we are getting the value of temperature, and this is a channel 3 and it is showing 43.8. and now see these channel 6, 7, 8, these are showing open circuit, means there are no connections there. At channel 2 we are getting 21.6, which is the temperature of air, and channel 3 we are getting humidity which is 43.6%, and other are showing open circuit, no connections. See, we have also set our range at this scanner module. For temperature it is 0 to 50 degree centigrade, we have set it 0 to 50, and for humidity it is 0 to 100% range. So we can change here humidity by, and I am just blowing air from my mouth to check with it will fluctuate humidity or not. And see, we are getting some fluctuation, we are increasing the humidity of air, and it is just increased a little bit. Thank you for watching our tutorial video.